Hi everybody. I want to share with you today something I just got in the mail yesterday. I didn't get a chance to look at it before I went to work. It is a RV85 Flare Launcher. I got this in a group buy on the, what is the website? The akforum.net. They had a group buy on purchasing these. It is supposed to be in the box as it was shipped directly from the Czechoslovakian BRNO facility, manufacturing facility, to the Czechoslovakian military. Apparently there was like 3,000 of these units produced. 1,000 of them were imported into the United States, some with original full kits, some without. This is an original full kit. Apparently this is the box as it was delivered from the military. Let's see here. We'll open it up. Let me take this box out. Set it aside so that we can get a better look at it. All right. Let's go ahead and open this up. We have a manual in Czechoslovakian. I really have no idea what this is. There is, I was already looking online before I received this. There is a website on the Cheaper Than Dirt forum. Somebody had posted English translations for these manuals. Everything is marked 321. 321. I'm guessing that's the serial number of the gun. This is a, is it a poster? Target? Ah, this is cool. Holy crap, I'd expect that. Okay, they ship a target with it. The target has a red outline of a rabbit on it. Little rabbit, it's got three holes in the center. Where it was test fired. It's got the information on here. This flare launcher, if you're not familiar with the RV85, it's a shoulder-fired flare launcher, and it was actually meant for, one of the uses was riot control. It was supposed to fire CS gas rounds that were able to penetrate barriers, and that's one of the uses of this thing. So, maybe that's why they needed it to be accurate. I don't know. It's pretty neat. This is pretty cool. We got a. This is the carrying case for it. Again, another manual marked 321. That's got to be the serial number. Okay, this is a night. Everything in here is dated 1987. Got a manual here. Obviously, this stuff's been sitting on a shelf somewhere since it was made in 87. We've got a full breakdown of the internals in this particular manual. I guess it's an illustrated parts manual of a sling. Yeah, just adjusting the camera a little bit. We have some small parts here. I have no idea what that is. Some springs here. No idea what that is. It's in a sealed bag. This is the cleaning kit, evidently. We have a coiled wire brush. If you purchase one of these things, one thing I did read on another forum from somebody who had purchased one of these a while ago, it was a complete kit, is this wound steel brush for cleaning the bore. The bore is chrome lined, but if you use it on a bore, they say it really scratches the heck out of it. You don't really want to use it on the bore. Use something else. Find a big shotgun brush or something, but don't use that. It said it really scratches it pretty bad. It makes it look terrible. All right, there's our cleaning kit. Everything's brand new, unissued. Wow, look at the mass of that. That is huge. I've never seen a flare launcher before. This thing is beefy. I'm gonna go get my, and it is serial numbered, serial number 321, so everything is serial numbered with it. I'm gonna go get my calipers and measure the wall thickness of this receiver here, so that we can get an idea of how much meat is there. All right, let's go ahead and measure this, and we'll check and see how much meat we have right here. On this portion of the gun, it looks like the barrel is sleeved inside this part here that attaches to the receiver. Let's go ahead and measure this and see how much meat is on here. 254. Well, it depends on how you hold it. It's the receiver metal is angled a little bit. 257. Anyway, it's about a quarter of an inch at least. Modern steel in there. So it's really strong. Not that you're going to need to, or anyone would need it to be too strong. It is, again, only for launching flares, even though it's supposed to be the same size as the old four-bore shotguns. Let's measure the exact bore of it and see what we come up with. The bore on this thing is a chrome lined. So if you buy one of these and you get into reloading your own rounds, if you're using black powder as a propellant, it'll aid you in cleaning it. Having a chrome lined bore will cut down on the corrosion as well. All right, let's see what we've got. Let's do a quick measurement. All right, 1048. All right, that's good enough. That gives us an idea. The bore is about 1 inch and plus maybe 50 thousandths. Let's take a look at the buttstock here. All right, there's the rear of it. It's got a rather narrow receiver. The rear receiver width is just over an inch itself. It's 1 inch and about 57 thousandths. Looks like it assembles easy enough. There's a pin here. Let's go ahead and put this together and see what the flare launcher looks assembled. I don't know which way this goes in, if there is a left or a right. Okay, it's in place. All right, that is neat. All right, here's a close-up look of the flare launcher. It's got a nifty buttstock. It's just like you'd find on a shotgun. It's got a rubber recoil pad. They must have fired some hefty rounds out of this thing, the military rounds, whatever they're... CS gas rounds were that they had designed to fire through barricades, which is what this was, one of the things this was meant for. They must have been pretty stout rounds. It's cool. It's almost like a cannon. Obviously it's not. It's just a flare launcher, but it's so cool. All right, flipping it back, let's take a closer look at the opening mechanism on this thing. Let's look at the bore on that. It's a chrome line bore. There's no chamber in it whatsoever. It's the one straight tube. All right, I never did see what was in this bag. I mean, I set it aside, but it's sealed on both ends, and it's something wrapped with that oil paper. Toolkit. Okay, well, this is the toolkit that I guess they would have shipped with it. I guess you got a special thing here. I have no idea what it is. Maybe for retrieving stuck cases from the chamber. Maybe snag them, pull them out. I don't know. Flat-bladed screwdriver and another flat-bladed screwdriver. Well, okay. That was interesting. Alright guys, thanks for watching this video. I hope you're not too disappointed with a simple overview of the RV85. I know you probably wanted to get to see this bad boy shoot, but you're not as disappointed as I am. Believe me, I really want to shoot it myself. If in the future you do want to see the future videos where I make the cartridges for it, go ahead and subscribe. I'm going to make a video on machining a cartridge case for it. Now, you don't have to machine them yourself. You can purchase these. If they're available online for 14 or 15 bucks, there's two or three different companies that are selling these 26.5 millimeter flare cartridges. I'll show you in the next videos on how to assemble your own smoke round cartridge, because that's what I'm going to concentrate on, is making these smoke rounds. And in those videos you also see how to make your own smoke mixture, fill it and launch it. I'm going to cover all of that. So if you do want to see that, go ahead and subscribe. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Keep in mind we do have more coming, and thanks for watching.